Over the last 25 years, I've had the privilege of interviewing and highlighting some truly interesting people. Everyone who is anyone, both the famous and the infamous, from presidents and their first ladies to kings and queens, movie stars and pop stars, captains of industry, heads of state, sports personalities, innovative entrepreneurs, and some pretty fascinating everyday people. Today, I'm proud to introduce you to Tyler Bray, an award-winning young entrepreneur and manager of the North Star Boys, the first Asian American content group. He believes that great ideas are indeed a dime a dozen, but great execution is the key to success. So before we get into your work with TK Trailer Parks and all the other things that you're doing, let's talk about your career path in some broader strokes. You've dabbled in acting and modeling, and I can see why. How did you discover your talent in front of a camera, first of all?
So the story goes, when I was around 16, 17 years old, I'm 5'5", 5'6", I'm not super tall, but I've always just wanted to be in front of the camera just because I thought it was the thing to do. Like, I thought it was the cool thing to do. I was a young teenager, and I just went knocking on doors on agencies and just trying to get signed. And most of them just turned me like at the receptionist desk. It's like, hey, you're too short. Sorry, try another place. Until I actually got picked up at a singing competition. One of the casting directors was a judge and she was like, hey, I like you look. And then I got signed on my 18th birthday to a modeling and acting agency. It just kind of happened. And I just think I was blessed to be in a situation where I could do that.
I'm sitting here thinking, so you start in front of the camera and then you put that brilliant little brain of yours to work and you start becoming an entrepreneur. So how has your innovation and leadership changed the game with regard to TK Trailer Parts and how that company does business?
So I think the biggest thing about business, especially in this ever-changing world, is constant evolution and innovation, right? And especially with how important social media is nowadays, your perception, especially online presence to the consumer, is what makes or break your business. And so having that experience being in front of the camera and knowing kind of what an audience looks for as far as audio and visuals, it helps me put into perspective what I need to do in terms of marketing my product, what the picture needs to look like, how my employees need to present themselves, and how I need to present myself in order to make my business successful.
And I think it's very smart of you to sort of put your communication skills into play, because marketing really starts with the ability to communicate in an effective way. So I read that you envision a, quote, reverse pyramid organizational structure for your business. You're gonna have to explain that to me. What do you mean by that?
So reverse pyramid, I think that many leaders believe that they're at the tip top and they command from the top down. My perspective on that is a leader is actually somebody who supports. I'm at the very bottom. The people at the top are my customers, my consumers, you know, whatever venture that I'm working on. And I'm at the bottom supporting the people. Let's say upper level management, those people support mid-level management. Those people support lower level team members, right? It's all a structure that supports one another rather than leading from the top down, almost like a dictatorship. So that's
and
the way
it makes sense, because then you motivate those who are what is perceived in the lower levels. You motivate them to move up because that makes you a more valuable team member.
That's right.
So I guess I have to ask you in what ways you brought some radical change, because you and I know that in order to really disrupt the market, you have to bring radical change. So let's talk about whatever radical change you brought in to make those changes and transformations at TK Trailer Parts.
So 2013 is when I started the business. I'm 23 years old now. So back when I first started the business, I was around 14 or 15 years old. And
you really were 14 or 15 when you created this business?
That's right.
I like that. Go right ahead.
And I, at that moment in time, it was part of the initial birth of, I guess you would say, e-commerce. Drop shipping wasn't a thing yet. And it was just like, okay, there's this online platform, this eBay, Amazon, and things of those nature that people are starting to sell on. And so I took a niche market, aftermarket trailer parts, that is predominantly something that you would buy on location, like a repair shop or things of that nature, and I put it online. So that doesn't really seem too exciting right now, but I was one of the first to do that. And on top of that, I was one of the first to create a total kit. Like, how do you build a trailer? This is everything you need to build a trailer except for the metal and the wood. And I put it all in a kit together, put it online, and people just started buying. And now everybody's online selling everything, including trailer parts. So it's hard to, stay competitive, which is why we're trying to hit the social media angle, hit different innovative products and things of that nature. But that was my first, game changer.
And it's what got you noticed and opened a whole bunch of doors, to be honest with you, because that's real innovation, Tyler, to actually know that there was a hole somewhere. I think it's fair to say at every aspect of my career over the past 30 years, I've looked for the holes in the marketplace. And if there's a hole, then that's a place that I feel like I might be able to fill that hole. And you did the exact same thing when it came to, as you say, aftermarket trailer parts. What's next? Come on, tell me something that you can share. Where you go now?
Well, going off of just what you said previously, the most important thing is finding a need and filling the need, right? If the need isn't currently being filled, that's how you become successful. It's that finding that market gap. And the current market gap that I'm personally serving right now, along with a bunch of my team and my friends and even my family, is me being the manager of North Star Boys, a Asian American group that we created, the very first one in America, actually. And especially with all the politics going on about stop Asian hate and minorities and Asians specifically, from my perspective, being underserved and under what's the terminology I would like to use? Like underrepresented.
Underserved.
Thank you. So yes, we're a group of seven, not including me as the manager, but seven boys, Asian Americans, who are growing really rapidly on social media, posting on every single platform. We're signed to an agency, WME, if you're familiar. And we're just trying to take the world by storm and show us that we are here. We're not just some stereotypical, what you would see, comedic Asians, feminized Asians. I mean, we're here and we're here to do work and become successful.
So you are a content provider, but it was started with the focus being, or the entrepreneurs being, young Asian American men. Is that correct?
So originally, actually, the focus was just young Asians, or sorry, young entrepreneurs,
Got it.
right? And it still is young entrepreneurs. What I want to show the Asian American community is that Asian Americans can also become successful being an Asian entrepreneur within America.
Oh, I got you. So basically, what you're doing is you're just showing a slice of life, and it just happens to be young Asian American entrepreneurs who are showing us that slice of life. Anybody could get access to this, but you guys are the ones that are opening these doors. I think that's very admirable, Tyler. I really do.
Thank you.
100%. So, what drives you to achieve success as an entrepreneur?
I had a, I wouldn't call it a revelation, but I had some introspective times to myself just to look at myself and think, okay, what is my calling, right? And this was just a few weeks ago, and I narrowed it down to two words, and it's to inspire. I have TK Trailer Parts, which is to inspire action. I want my company to be able to provide people the parts and pieces to do what they want, build a trailer, repair a trailer, right? In my entrepreneurial journeys personally, I want to be able to inspire young entrepreneurs to do it, even if they're 14, 15, 16. In my North Star, which is this Asian American influencer group, I want to be able to inspire Asian Americans just in general, right? So it's really what makes me wake up in the morning is I want to inspire, and I want to inspire not only the people around me, my family, my friends, but also everybody who sees what I'm doing. I want to inspire by example.
Fantastic. And since you brought up family and friends, let's talk a little bit about family. What role do you say that your family has played in your personal and professional success? They raised a pretty smart kid if at 14, 15 you started all of this.
Thank you. Thank you. My family, I would have to say, is the reason for my success. Everything and every the person who I am today is because of the way that I was raised. I could thank my mother, my stepdad, my father. I'm also the oldest of nine kids altogether. So that's taught me leadership skills, you know, voluntarily or involuntarily. I'm not very sure, but it's definitely taught me to become that big, protective older brother. I always want to be a good role model to them. I always want to make them proud of me. I always want to make my parents proud of me. I mean, it's just my mom specifically pushes me every single day to become the best version of me. And I keep that mentality everywhere I go.
That's sort of what us moms do. I have a 16-year-old son, and I love to hear his innovative ideas. I have to tell you, though, he thinks of things that I never thought of at 15 and 16. So your generation is to be admired. And I think a number of people will find inspiration. Where do you see the future of your business, Tyler?
The future of my business, I actually just went to a kind of a business boot camp, I would call it. And we did a deep dive on my current business state and where I want to take it. And I have a few options. I honestly haven't pinned down exactly what I want to do with it, but it's doing great right now. And as long as my business is able to give me enough capital to pursue different ventures and opportunity, that's where I would like to be big picture. But it's growing at an amazing pace right now. I have an amazing team set back in Texas. I'm in LA right now, and I don't really have to worry about anything. And with my team, we're going into manufacturing, not just distribution, but manufacturing. We're going to grow into all different markets globally, and we're going to keep innovating products and making sure that we bring the best products to our customers.
Fantastic. I love that you have short-term and long-term goals so that you just can keep innovating, keep creating, and keep moving forward. As we end, tell me, what's the one thing you'd like the viewer of this video feature to walk away with?
The one thing that I would like them to walk away with is I just want, whether the viewer is, you know, older, a parent, or even a kid who's 14, 15 in middle school or high school, to see that it's possible. Whatever it is that you want to do, it's possible as long as you put in the work, as long as you dedicate yourself, as long as you make the sacrifices. I was 14 years old. I dropped out of high school, ninth grade, to do what I wanted to do. I'm 23 now. I moved away from my family to pursue this career path in California. And now I'm with a great group of friends trying to inspire Asian Americans. Like, it's possible, right? Age isn't a factor. You know, my minority status isn't a factor either. I just got to push, and you could do it. You can.
And Tyler, let me just add this one thing to your story. When preparation meets opportunity, there's nothing that can stop you. And it looks like you have been preparing all your very young life to get to this point. Congratulations and good luck with the future.
Thank you.